And using that QR code, you'll be able to find our worship aid. Again, at number 978 in the One in Faith hymnal has the readings. And we'll begin our Ash Wednesday Mass in just a few moments.
Our opening hymn is found in your hymnal, number 419, number 419.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
So we do gather together on this first day of Lent, Ash Wednesday, recognizing that we are called to return to the Lord in every aspect of our lives. Our penitential act tonight will be the reception of ashes on our forehead. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evils, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Joel. Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your hearts, not your garments, and return to the Lord your God. For gracious and merciful is he, slow to anger, rich in kindness, and relenting in punishment. Perhaps he will again relent and leave behind him a blessing, offerings and libations for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion, proclaim a fast, call an assembly, gather the people, notify the congregation, Assemble the elders, gather the children and the infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom quit his room and the bride her chamber. Between the porch and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep and say, Spare, O Lord, your people, and make not your heritage a reproach with the nations ruling over them. Why should they say among the peoples, Where is their God? Then the Lord was stirred to concern for his land and took pity on his people. The word of the Lord.
Wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt. And of my sin cleanse me. Be merciful.
Be merciful, O
Lord, for we have sinned. For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is before me always. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Be merciful, be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. A clean heart prepare for me, O God, and a willing spirit sustain in me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. Be merciful, be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are ambassadors for Christ, as if God were appealing through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, He made him to be sin who did not know sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Working together, then, we appeal to you not to receive the grace of God in vain. For he says, "In an acceptable time I heard you, and on the day of salvation I helped you. Behold, now is a very acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation." The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Take care not to perform righteous deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no recompense from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received the reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right is doing, so that your almsgiving may be secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, who love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on the street corners, so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go into the inner room, close the door, and pray to your Father in secret. And your Father, who sees in secret, will repay you. When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that you may not appear to be fasting, except to your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you." The Gospel of the Lord.
God calls us through the prophet Joel in our first reading. Return to me with your whole heart. Your whole heart. God asks nothing less of us than our entire selves. All of our love, all of our spiritual efforts, every aspect of our lives. Many times we want to keep back part of ourselves. Sometimes it's the best of us that we do not want to give to God, for we can use it for our advantage and therefore may very well not use it in the way that God intends us to. Or sometimes it's the worst of us that we will hold on to. Some sinful areas that we do not want to let go of. Or we may be embarrassed to bring our worst to God, to allow the light of Christ to expose us. And yet to do so, if we allow that to happen, we start the process of healing. God wants us to return to Him as we are, with all of our defects, wounds, and scars. For when we do so, God can make us whole. In turning over our hearts to God, we can begin to heal from our brokenness, to be transformed away from sin, and to grow in charity. Return to the Lord. We are encouraged. The more that we do this, the more this sets us free to live as God desires. Let us be hopeful as we take these 40 days to really give to God everything, to return to God in every aspect of our lives. I think it's powerful that in the gospel tonight we hear repeated two times, your Father who sees in secret will repay you. And really almost three times, because he says it again with just one word changed. Your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you. We don't know how successful we will be entering into this Lenten season. We pray that we will grow very, very fruitful. And yet, we don't know, but God will see our efforts. And we can grow closer to God even as we struggle to turn fully to Him in every aspect of our lives. So know that there is something very beautiful happening. Even if we need to restart our Lenten practices over and over again, God sees. God knows what is hidden, we will be repaid. What is in secret, we will be repaid. So we know that that effort that we make is something very pleasing to God. Let us return to the Lord who gives us everything. The Lord who promises life after death, promises joy even after sorrow. The Lord is the only one who can fully make us whole. So at this time, we will bless the ashes in which we will distribute this evening. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly ask God our Father that He be pleased to bless with the abundance of His graces these ashes, which we will put on our heads in penitence. O God, who desire not the death of sinners, but their conversion, mercifully hear our prayers. And in your kindness, be pleased to bless these ashes, which we intend to receive upon our heads, that we who acknowledge we are but ashes and shall return to dust, may through a steadfast observance of Lent gain pardon for sins and newness of life, after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Keep me.
Let us stand for our prayers of the faithful. The sign of ashes invites us to respond to the God who calls us to come back to him. Let us do so with faith as we present these, our prayers.
For all the members of our community, as we repent and do penance during this chosen time, let us pray to the Lord. For a renewed spirit of peace throughout the world and an end to aggression in Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord. For a strong generosity to the poor and oppressed during this season, let us pray to the Lord. For the return to the sacrament of reconciliation, let us pray to the Lord. For those who are sick and who are dying, for those who have died, and for those names written in the St. Jude Book of Intentions, let us pray to the Lord. For the repose of the soul of Margaret Stemninsky, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, look upon the petitions of your people, those that we have spoken, those that we lift up in our hearts as we begin this Lenten season. And we ask you to receive them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we entreat you, O Lord, that through works of penance and charity, we may turn away from harmful pleasures and cleanse from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help to imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Tempore sum. season. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sic erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we do have a special blessing as we begin the season of Lent. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
Pour out a spirit of compunction, O God, on those who bow before your majesty. And by your mercy, may they merit the rewards you promise to those who do penance, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is found in your hymnal number 424, number 424, Out of the Depths.